Jessica Van Meter.
Welcome back. Happy Sunday morning to you. Big day for Colorado sports up in Denver. We got a lot of cloud cover this morning. Rockies going to be taking on the Brewers later on today for that game. Things get going around 2:30 this afternoon. Temperature is going to be in the 50s, a little cool up at Coors Field. And we're also going to have some increasing shower chances as we go throughout the baseball game there. Broncos are going to be at the Jets on the East Coast. Temperatures will run a little warmer in the 70s. Generally pretty dry. Clouds will be around, but games should be able to get going before the rain arrives. So hopefully a dry day and a win for the Broncos and the Rockies as well. Now, right now around our area, we do have some areas of low visibility, especially around El Paso County. That's where that fog is really densest, under a mile for many areas around Colorado Springs. Keep your headlights on as you head out this morning. We're at 40 degrees around Colorado Springs, 46 in Pueblo. We've still got a lot of that low level cloud cover, but the fog is not quite as bad for Pueblo this morning. We will see a lot of that cloud cover really sticking around throughout the day, and we'll also have a chance for a few isolated showers during the day. During the daytime hours, most of us do stay on the drier side of things. The rain chances really ramp up as we get into the evening. As far as temperatures go, 50s for the higher elevation areas of Teller, northern El Paso County, mid upper 50s, even some low 60s around the Colorado Springs area. A few degrees warmer than yesterday, but still below average for this time of year. We'll make it into the 60s around Pueblo, 50s and 60s for areas of the plains. Now, as far as our shower activity goes, as I said, it's going to be pretty minor throughout the day today. We'll see a few showers here and there, but they won't amount to much during our daytime hours. That cloud cover, though, can be pretty intense and stay in place for the lower elevation areas. Higher elevation areas will try to improve those skies a little bit, see a little more sunshine in the mix. Now, as we get into the evening hours, those shower chances really do ramp up by about 8 p.m. See some more activity getting going along that I-25 corridor, potentially some thunderstorms for areas of the southern plains. And those shower chances will continue through the overnight hours and into early tomorrow morning. So we'll keep that chance for mainly later in the day shower activity around Colorado Springs today. That'll continue into Monday, Tuesday. Also going to have a good chance at seeing some of that shower activity after today. Temperatures drop a few degrees heading into Tuesday. We're only in the 40s for our highs. Should be our coldest day of the next several days. Tuesday night, also the coldest night heading our way, with temperatures potentially dipping below freezing around Colorado Springs. The rest of the week, temperatures getting a little warmer, back into the 50s. Could see another chance for some shower activity late Thursday into Friday. Pueblo will keep that chance for showers pretty minor for today and tomorrow. Better chances of arriving on Tuesday with those cooler temperatures, highs only in the 50s there, back into the 60s starting on Wednesday. In Canyon City, we'll see that chance for showers mainly later today and then into Monday and Tuesday. Tuesday's going to feel pretty chilly with highs only in the upper 40s. After that, we do get a little warmer for the rest of the week. Again, a chance for a couple stray showers Thursday into Friday. Woodland Park and those higher elevation areas, we'll see some slightly better chances for showers and potentially even a little bit of flakes mixing in. Could see a little bit of that snow flying for those higher elevation areas. We'll see that chance later today, Monday, Tuesday. Notice those overnight lows, especially Monday night and Tuesday night, getting down into the 20s. So